Let me just say that I think this is probably one of the best gifts we've got in Galaxy of Heroes, mainly because this faction is pretty darn free to play. And I just threw the Zeta on the Geonosian and Brood Alpha yesterday, but I honestly think this is a team that doesn't really need Zetas to be a very good team. The Zetas do help bring it a little bit more to a more competitive level, but honestly, unlike a lot of other factions that need at least one or two Zetas minimum to get working, you really don't need any Zetas to get this team pumping and getting you some big wins. And the other beautiful thing, besides these other free-to-play characters that have been in the game for such a long time, they also have no Zetas with their reworks. That is a beautiful, beautiful thing, people. And plus, a lot of these other characters have ships. So there's so many layers of what you're getting for this team. You're getting a great team, as we're going to talk about today. Really no Zetas to make this team work, and they're needed for ships, and they're going to be very important for a Geonosian territory battle. And fifth, these have some of the best gear 13 upgrades, and these guys are currently my gear 13 project I'm working on because of that fact. So with that brief summary at the beginning out of the way here, let's start doing some testing. Now, if you watched the video a while ago, I ranked all of the pretty much like the top 30-ish teams in Galaxy Heroes. If you haven't seen that video, click on the card in the top right-hand corner. And an important resource, if you're trying to figure out what kind of beats what's a better team than what, check out that video. We are going to do a slight revision here. Mainly, we're going to restart renaming the titles. Instead of Tier 0, Tier 1, Tier 2, we're going to kind of go by the Grand Arena Championship tiers by talking about Kyber, Erodium, Chromium, Bronzium, and Carbonite. I think it's a bit more fitting since these videos are more geared towards Grand Arena, and probably next month we're gonna have a brand new graphic and we're gonna have a more rankings going on here. So what I'm gonna do is basically show you footage of the Geonosians and their reworks going up against pretty much each and every one of these top three tiers, because that's gonna be the most important area to understand how good Geonosians are. So starting off with the Kyber tier, what can you expect with Geonosians being on the offensive and defensive? And before we actually get to answer that point, I gotta say firstly, if you're gonna use the Geonosians, I honestly think the best place to use them is going to be defense in Grand Arena Championships. Zarth Revan, it's going to easily beat Geonosians on offensive defense, kind of to be expected. Jedi Knight Revan easily gets through Geonosians if Geonosians are on defense. Geonosians against Jedi Knight Revan on defense, you can put a scratch in Jedi Knight Revan. I can't say you're going to beat Jedi Knight Revan, but there's been a couple times where I got pretty darn close to beating a Jedi Knight Revan team, but it's not easy. So I'm not going to tell you try to go after Jedi Knight Revan of Geonosians, but you might be able to put a couple scratches in them. Now, moving on to our Erodium tier, which is the second highest tier in the game. This is where we start seeing some interesting things revolving the Geonosians. Now, firstly, the first few teams that come to mind when you think of the second tier in the game, Erodium, is that you got Padme, General Grievous, Commander Luke, Treya, and a couple of other things. Those are kind of the big name teams you kind of want to know about. General Grievous easily demolishes Geonosians, whether they're on offense or defense. They really have no chance. One of the biggest weaknesses of these Geonosians is the massive amounts of AoE damage coming on, because Geonosians succeed in one-on-one combat, but if there is AoE damage just being splattered everywhere, Geonosians don't have enough of a health pool to kind of keep up with that massive amounts of damage, and that's why General Grievous is an easy way to counter the Geonosians. Interesting enough though, Padme Amidala and Commander Luke Skywalker can struggle big time up against the Geonosians. Honestly, one of the biggest highlights, if you're trying to figure out, all right, what's the biggest thing that the Geonosians can beat? Honestly, Commander Luke Skywalker teams, that is huge. I mean, the Commander Luke Skywalker teams, no matter if they're in offense or defense, Commander Luke struggled each and every battle, and a lot of the battles lasted under a minute. Commander Luke slowly falling out of favor now. Geonosians are giving them quite a hard time. So I mean you might be able to win with Commander Luke Skywalker once in a while, but the testing I've done, he won zero times offense or defense up against the Geonosians. That is the biggest highlight. So Geonosians, with even without the Zeta, should be a decent counter up against Commander Luke Skywalker. Now Padme Amidala, another big highlight. This is a bit more of a caveat. Depending on the Padme Amidala lineup, Geonosians can win. I tried it up against the best Padme Amidala team, which is Padme with C-3PO, and just Padme couldn't get anything done because of the constant buff dispels coming from Sunfag, as well as the critical hits from the Geonosian Brood Alpha. They can keep dispelling the protection up, meaning they're going to remove the stacks of potential courage or that protection up that they're getting. And the problem with Padme is By and large, the Galactic Republic has some pretty low damage output, and they rely heavily on being able to convert protection into courage. But if they keep getting all those protection up buffs this spell, they can't get the damage output they need to kind of override the massive amount of health and protection and the rebalancing going on a Geonosian team. So you gotta be careful. If you're gonna bring Padme up against them, use the right lineup. And honestly, one of the best ways I found to beat Geonosians is Padme Amidala with Clone Wars Chewbacca. Now, you don't have to use Clone Wars Chewbacca, but the point I'm trying to make here is it seems like Padme Amidala with two tanks is going to be the best way to ensure you're going to get a lot of stacks of courage to pile up. And what I mean by that is, if you have two tanks going, the Geonosians just can't keep going everywhere, dispelling protection up, except for the AoE from Brood Alpha, which can dispel all buffs from the enemies he's hitting. But by and large, I found if I had two tanks, Clone Wars Chewbacca and General Kenobi standing side by side, the Geonosians couldn't get the Padme and also Ahsoka and whoever else I had in the third slot. They had a hard time getting in there and just ripping off those protection up buffs. And that's how I ended up winning. Next up in this Erodium tier, we have to talk about Darth Revan without Darth Malak. Now, Darth Revan and Darth Malak, they're a whole different beast. But without Malak, Darth Revan is a lot more manageable. And Darth Revan without Malak can still beat Geonosians, but I've had a few battles where we at least took out one character with the Geonosians. Now, Treya and the Triumvirate. This is honestly one of the best counters to the Geonosians because of all the attacks out of turn and the critical hits and all that other stuff, the buffs that are being spread out of turn. This is Treya and her team counters everything in regards to Geonosians, and Treya can just pick them off one by one, and it's pretty. Darth Nihilus can get his Annihilates out pretty quickly. Once you take out the Brood Alpha, just by and large, this is going to be an easy way for you to just pick off the rest, because once the Brood Alpha is gone, you throw Isolate, let's say, on the Brute, so the Taunt stop, and then you just annihilate the Brood Alpha, the team falls apart. The goal is still the same. Even before the reworks, the goal was take out the Brood, game over. And Night Sisters with Ness. Now, this is going to be an easy way to beat Geonosians, and Geonosians can struggle up against this team as well. Now, Geonosians could take out all the Night Sisters, but Geonosians can struggle with Ness if they can't time out the Silent Strike capability from the Geonosian spy to get the one hit to wipe out Ness. You can either time out against Ness, or Ness could time out against the Geonosians. It's kind of a hit or miss, but by and all, Night Sisters are going to be an easy way to counter the Geonosians. Since we're on the topic of Ness for a brief second, last week I made a guide showing how to solo teams with Enfys Ness, and in that video, we went up against unreworked Geonosians with the Brood Alpha, and I showed you that if you use Kira, Ness, as well as Hermit Yoda, you could win, but you're going to be coming down to like a minute or 30 seconds left. Now, in case you're curious, trying to solo Geonosians with Ness is going to be even more difficult than before, if there's any chance, because they keep attacking over and over again. You might get ability blocked due to Pog of the Lesser constantly assisting, or you might get dazed, or you might get blind. It's a lot more difficult than before, and I haven't won all the battles like I was before against Geonosians, so I don't know if I would recommend taking your Ness, trying to solo Geonosian squad, because it is a high-risk lineup. All right, so now this Chromium tier, which is going to be your third-tier characters or teams in the game, this is going to be an important one. One, because Geonosians weed out a lot of these teams. A lot of these teams will not be able to handle this. Also, on the flip side, this is going to be important for you trying to take out Geonosians, because you don't really want to dip into those top two tier teams that we just talked about up until this point, because you want to save those for more of the difficult things out there. This is where you want to try to find your counters and also the tiers going below this to take out the Geonosians. And honestly, the best third tier team that can win is going to be Emperor Palpatine. Now, Emperor Palpatine in this Chromium tier, he's kind of like one of those good all-around characters. And when I talk about Emperor Palpatine, I mainly tested out a full Empire team, assuming you don't want to put too many Sith in here. Sith will work well. You got a lot of flexibility. But honestly, one of the biggest weaknesses for the Geonosians is just too many debuffs. Yes, they can cleanse, but cleansing just feeds the Palpatine train too much stuns, too much shock, too much damage over time. When you spam all these debuffs over there and you start just harvesting the Terminator, you just run circles around them, and eventually it does take a while because they keep rebalancing. But after a while, you just destroy the team, and once you take out the Brood Alpha, which is probably going to be your first target, it's just game over at that point. But honestly, the rest of these Chromium tier characters had a hard time winning. Even teams like Bastila Shan, the Jedi, have a hard time going up against Geonosians. Even the unreworked Geonosians gave Bastila Shan and her Jedi a hard time. Now, it seems almost impossible for Bastilshan and her fellow Jedi to take out a Geonosian team because they just have too many buffs, and the Geonosians, they rely on those buffs, and when the Geonosians keep attacking out of turn, they just quickly get rid of the bonus protection that Bastila gives, and after the bonus protection drops, it's game over. Even if you have Jolie Bindo trying to get these Jedi to revive, it's just not enough to win. So even Bastilshan Jedi can struggle. We did some Jedi training raid testing, and even depending on what type of lineup you ran, I mean, there might be a Jedi training raid lineup that worked better, but the lineups that I was testing with Jedi training raid, man, she just got decimated. She couldn't get anything going. Too many buff dispels. And the problem is, which is one thing I kind of foresee happening in the future, is that taunts mean diddly squat up against a Geonosian team, which makes me wonder if the developers are going to eventually develop some sort of undispellable taunt. Fosk lead and Jango lead. We also tried a Boba Fett lead with a lot of thermal detonators. We're going to talk about Jawas towards the end. I haven't forgotten about it. I just want to save it more towards the end right now. But Bosk lead, Jango lead, just they couldn't do it. They couldn't pull off any sort of win. I mean, they weren't even close, it felt like. And then we tried Boba Fett lead because if you watch the Jawa engine, the Jawa video we put out yesterday, Jawas, as of now, are going to be the best counter to the Geonosians. You just do nothing and you win. You got to watch the video to understand the full strategy. But the idea I was trying to try with Boba Fett is maybe Boba Fett with his thermal detonator synergy and a thermal detonator heavy team could beat a Geonosian squad. However, the bounty hunters, they just don't apply as many thermal detonators as the Jawa crew was able to do. There's a chance that Jawa crew could get fixed slash nerfed. So that's why I'm not talking about it too extensively right now. But by and large, it just felt like bounty hunters couldn't get the job done. They just weren't getting enough out there in order to kind of overcompensate for the amount of health and protection the Geonosians were generating. First Order was a team that kind of almost won. There's a lot of stuns, a lot of buff dispels, and a lot of survivability on a First Order team, but it's very tedious. You got to make sure you stun Poggle, make sure you stun the Brute Alpha, make sure you try to stun the Brute as well so he doesn't taunt, and we were getting somewhere. But it's going to be a tricky battle. It's going to be a very long and arduous battle to kind of pull off. So I don't know if First Order are going to be as good of a counter as Emperor Palpatine. We didn't get too much success, but they were showing some potential. And then lastly, I just want to talk about a few teams in the Bronzium tier, which is where you're going to get a couple of decent teams. And the only team I really want to talk about, because everyone's like, oh my gosh, I want to see clones up against the Geonosians. It's not looking good for clones. Clones still need some work done. They didn't really have a chance. I mean, really, the team was relying on the Clone Sergeant. The Clone Sergeant might have been able to pull off a big win, and if your Clone Sergeant dies off too early, the team falls apart. But just getting the massive damage from Clone Sergeant over and over again seemed to be the key to potentially beat a Geonosian lineup. But I'm thinking the clones are going to get kind of like the treatment that the Geonosians got, where they got a good leader to help out these unreworked characters, but eventually the rest of the crew got a rework. And also, one of the actually surprising counters in this tier is New Gunnery. Now, you guys, if you've been following me for a while, I've been singing praises about the New Gunnery rework. I think it's one of the most interesting and one of the most fabulous reworks, and especially it's such an easily accessible character. The extortion mechanic really just destroys the Geonosian faction. And furthermore, what I really, really like, which I think is one of the reasons why this was successful, is New Gunnery with Count Dooku. Luckily, these are two characters you don't really need anywhere. Just having Count Dooku constantly stun, apply shocks, and letting New Gunnery get the extortion to stick around, it just starts spreading, and extortion and all this other stuff just starts dwindling away at the team. We tossed in a couple of their characters one time, and Sunfac and Wampa didn't do anything. It was really New Gunnery and Dooku carrying the whole entire win. And speaking of massive AoE damage, really, when you think of massive AoE damage, the Grievous Nuke teams that we've been kind of experimenting with lately that can sometimes beat a Darth Revan, Darth Malak team, that's actually a team that Geonosians cannot beat on offense or defense. So droids and their massive AoE damage might just be enough to take out these Geonosians. But again, you need fast droids and you need lots of AoE damage spamming them. And really, the Nuke team revolves around Grievous constantly getting in to do a big AoE ability. So I don't know if droids overall be a counter, but as of now, Nuke team droids can get the job done up against Geonosians if they're that big of a concern for you. But overall, this is a great team. Yeah, the Kyber tiers as well as the Erodium tiers, they can handle the Geonosians very well. But once you get to that Chromium tier and everything below it, that's where the Geonosians really shine. And again, you don't need Zetas to make this team work. They're a super free-to-play, accessible team. We haven't had something like this in quite a long time. I mean, usually when you have a brand new team, they're locked behind, first of all, a Chromium pack only or something, or they're thrown into a hard node right away. Basically, all of these Geonosians have been in the game free-to-play for a long time, and even the the newest character, Brood Alpha, isn't really that difficult to farm. It's something that was went straight free to play right away for people to get. So this is going to be a great team. And we didn't even talk about other things beyond Grand Arena, but this is going to be an important team for Geonosis territory. They're needed almost everywhere for this, and probably in the future with Separatist ships on the rise, as we're speculating, these are going to probably be important for the future Separatist fleet sometime down the road. Take advantage of the Geonosians, their free-to-play accessibility, and really the fact that they don't need a lot of Zetas should be a very important strategic tool for Grand Arena and really mess up your enemy. Like the video if you did enjoy. Comment down below on your thoughts of the Geonosians, and be sure to subscribe so you're not missing a thing, and I'll talk to you lovely people in the next video. Peace out, everyone.
Party Richter! Party Richter!
Get down, 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 down.
Party Richter! Party Richter!
Son of a bitch!
Party Richter! Party Richter!
Get down, down, down.